Hi guys, VTech here on Blueberry Hill. So this is January 13th to the 20th. Took several days to get all the stuff compiled for the water filtration system and stuff. Just need a bunch of fittings and pipes and all that fun stuff. So it was a little bit of work here and then wait and get some parts and then come back and do some more. So anyway, might be called poor planning. I don't know. Anyway, took a few days and I think the weather was kind of goofy a couple times. So anyway, here we are. So let me comment on what I'm doing here. So the first order of business was putting the panel up. It's roughly 3/4 of a 4x8 sheet of plywood, and then I started working on the tank. The tank's going to go right to the right of the panel, and as you can see me there, I'm assembling the pipes that go into the tank. There's actually a pressure control valve built on the tank. I bought the kit for that, and needless to say, I bought a very good pump with a pressure controller on it as well, and it's digital, so it actually is little overkill on that. I'm not going to use the one that you just saw on the tank. I'm using the one on the pump itself. Anyway, the rest of the system was put together with a bunch of PEX piping, 1-inch, a bunch of brass fittings, and quite a few elbows, etc. And you'll see me assembling the tank. In a little bit, you'll see me assembling the filter system. Did have a couple goofy things happen. Two things were broken from two Amazon orders for the filtration system, so that took a couple days to get that replaced. They were awesome in replacing it, but it took 2 days to get the parts on reorder. Anyway, so here you see me working on the pump. That's a Raintech HP pump. It's a 1 horsepower, and that round thing you see on top of it, that's the actual digital controller, and you can preset the pressure you want to come out of it to the house or whatever. So the output from the tank, the pump is going to go into the tank. The tank is a pressure tank, and we'll probably run it around, you know, most people do around 60 psi, upwards of 60 psi. Since the tank, rainwater tank, is uphill and the house is downhill, we might have to actually lower that pressure just a bit and see what happens. So if you're watching closely, you'll see me putting valves in a bunch of places. There's a valve right behind the tank, the main one on kind of a T-pipe from the pressure tank. I now have another shutoff tank valve here. They're all PEX shutoff valves. I have several that go in place. And if you pay close attention, you'll see me doing elbows, like the one right above the valve. That's going to be a T, so you'll see it change from a 90 degree to a T. Because I want to bypass over the system in case I have to shut stuff off. And that's just so I can empty the filters when I need to, etc., etc. So when you see me installing these filters, these are the second ones we've got. They're not broken. They're the replacements of the broken ones, and they went in just fine. You'll see me install a UV filter thingy in a minute. Here you see me actually. So here's the 90 degree T fitting going in. I think I just went to go get it. Yep, there it is. I'm going to replace that. Yep, try to pry it off. Oh, and look, magically you see the T-fitting there. So, you know, I did that twice actually. You'll see it later on. Here, down the left, you'll see the clamps for the UV filter. And that's it's a VP950 version. That was actually cheaper than the VP600, which is the more popular, smaller model. This one does more volumes per gallons per minute, so I chose this one. Has the same exact controller as the 600 version, just a little bigger capacity on this version, this filter. So after installing the filter, I noticed that the fittings, I didn't read the instructions. All the other filters, the VP600s and below, come with 1-inch pipe thread for connecting to stuff. These are 1.5. I didn't have those connectors, so I did mostly what I could here, and then the next day I came back with the right fittings and everything worked out. You'll see me putting those together. So here you see me working on the overhead bypass. I'll have several valves that actually bypass all the different parts of the system, so we can take the filters apart, etc. Here I had to stop doing the bypass because I kind of ran out of PEX. Next you'll see me working on the pump. I had enough for that, so continued working on that section and got some more pegs the next day and some PVC to finish the piping to the tank. So although it's not necessary to do a water meter, I thought it was a good idea to have it just so we can actually count the gallons we consume. Otherwise, you really don't know what's going on. But, you know, from a normal house, I think we were consuming like 1,500 a month. That included some sprinkler system action and stuff like that. We're not going to have sprinklers here unless we do a little garden. That's not going to be from the rainwater harvesting tank. But anyway, it's a good idea to count, I think. So, here it is the next day. I came back and started working on the fittings on the UV filter. You can see the PVC, it's 1.5 inch, and then I put the brass fittings for the PEX line in there, and then just continue to put stuff together. And I'm using the clips for the PEX. It's you might have seen the tool being used. So you put it around the pipe and then squeeze and it'll click it shut. Works pretty good. So in this little section, I'm putting a another pressure gauge on the output from the UV filter, just to see what's going out. There's one on the, of course, on the pump, and there's another one at the bottom of the tank. So we'll have kind of redundancy there. But I just want to make sure we're running at the right levels, not over pumping or under pumping for the house. So here's Pop supervising me doing the last little bit that connects the PEX to the water meter. I actually got a 100-foot roll of this stuff and we couldn't really straighten it out very well, so wasn't too happy about that. But anyway, it was good enough to finish it up right to the meter. And you can see the nice bent PEX pipe going to the water meter, so it worked out, one less connection. Two less elbows, I guess. But anyway, so there it is. There's the system. And I just have to put something on the left side of the meter to shut off water since we don't have the house finished. So next order of business was to actually hook up the input pipe from the tank to the pump, and I decided to just go straight through the wall right there. I was going to run the PVC along the wall on the inside of the building. I figured, what the heck, so I punched a hole right there, went straight out, and I'm going to go right underneath our water collection pipes, all buried under the ground, so that should keep things nice and safe and actually warmer than just being out in the shop like that. Anyway, so I'm putting the PVC together. I was going to run PEX from here to the tank, but since we couldn't uncoil it, we decided to do the PVC all the way up, and you'll see that next little bit here. So there you can see the little hole. It's roughly a little bit over a 1 inch hole in the wall, and I have a 45 degree angle that's going to go from that 90 degree fitting to get a small filter. And a lot of people don't put the sediment filter on it. I find that really strange because stuff still settles in the tank. It might be a little bit, but you don't want that stuff to go through the pump. So I decided to do a sediment filter right there, and then the pump obviously pumps the water through the main sediment filter, and then a fine filter, micron level stuff, and then the UV filter. So a lot of three levels of redundancy ish, but it's all to keep the equipment nice and safe. here we are on the outside. Obviously, you can see the pipe sticking out through the wall. I'm going to go straight down, and we're going to bury the one inch PVC out here. We're just going to bury it with road base and then some gravel right beside the building, so it should be nice and covered. There's not going to be any traffic in this area either, so well, hopefully not. And we'll just let it look rocky. So there. So I'll do a little bit of digging to uncover the water inlet pipe from the downspouts. And the PVC for the water from the tank is just going to run along the side, and we're just going to bury this whole area. And in a little bit, you're going to see what we do to the... We're going to use the drain from the tank as our water source. We're not going to have... A lot of people put in-tank pumps that are dropped inside the tank, and they have to pump water over the edge of the tank and down and into your house or whatever. We don't need that because our elevation is above grade. The tank's 6-7, maybe even 8 feet above the shop. So gravity fed, I think that's going to work out great, and the pump's not going to have to work too hard. And decided just to use the drain from the tank. It was there. You'll see me installing a secondary valve so we can drain the tank if we ever have to. But anyway, it looked like an easy solution, and we have a dry pump running the whole system. So there's about a, I don't know, 6 to 12 inches of fill here. That's for the tank itself. So I just basically used a pickaxe and made a trench for the 1-inch pipe that's going to go in there. And next you're going to see me putting the valve thing together. And Angie and I basically just tucked the PVC inside the trench and connected it all together, and we're good to go. The bad part is I kind of ran out of battery on a stupid GoPro. So the last few connections you're not going to see on camera. I'll take pictures and stuff later. But anyway, it is what it is. So there's Angie collecting the PEX that we didn't use. Fantastic. It's not cheap. It's 3 or 4 times the price of PVC. It's probably better, but easier to use if you have it straight. So there you go. So here you're going to see me putting the valve together. You can see the blue valve right there, black and blue. It's a 2-inch pipe, so we basically just fit a 2-inch PVC into it. And I did use, you might have seen me using a yellow tube of pipe sealer. It's Teflon-based pipe sealer. I love using that stuff. I don't like Teflon tape much because it doesn't work as well. Since the sealer's actually kind of always stays sort of wet and pliable, it seals extremely well. Anyway, here you see me just putting PVC stuff together. So I put a T in there, and then I put a pool valve. You can see the valve in front of me there. If we have to empty the tank at any point, it'll be there. I figured that was a simple solution. And then the 1-inch pipe, we do a reducer. You can also see that right beside my beer. and that'll supply the water to the filtration system and into the house. We're doing 1-inch feed into the house, and then we're going to have a big manifold that spreads out the water to all the parts that need it. So pretty straightforward stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Enjoy. Come on back. Hit the like button and subscribe if you want to. Later. Bye.